excited about. My daughter made me a new intro video. I just said, oh, just put something together real quick so I have something I can plunk in the beginning of the video. Well, she went above and beyond. I'm just so proud of her, and I'm so thankful for my girl, Becca. Thank you, girly. Love you. My project. Some of you know I did a 365-day cup project where I made a cup a day for a year, and actually, that was in 2011. I mean, some of you may have just found that project, you know, a month ago, but I actually did it in 2011 for the whole year, a cup a day, and then 2012, they were in the galleries, and then I sold them after that within 2012 and 2013. Remodeled our house, sporadic projects in 2013, 2014, here we are. I'm ready to start another project like that, like the 365 project, not as grand because I have other things I want to accomplish. So to put it into my hobby cracks of time, I want to do 30 bowls, 30 days, 30 techniques. And I have it, I looked down, you saw me look down. I have it all charted out how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna, how many bowls I'm gonna make a day, how long they're gonna dry, how long I'm gonna glaze, you know, that type of thing. And then the 30 techniques I have listed here too. Some of them are actually how I'm gonna make the bowl, techniques on how to make the bowl, techniques on how to glaze, techniques on how to decorate. But I don't even know everything I wrote down here. Some of these I haven't even tried before, so I'm really excited to try them. And that's the point. I'm gonna stretch myself, but I don't wanna start everything new. I do have some techniques that I like using, so I'm gonna see how to make those grow as well. But hopefully you guys enjoy the 30-day series, and yeah, I'm really ready to get started on it and show you something new. So hopefully you guys will enjoy today's clip. And I'm ready to get started. Today I want to show you some glazing, and the reason is I need to clean these shelves off in order to do my 30-day project. I'm not one to enjoy having bisquares stored in boxes, so I'll glaze it, see how it turns out, and so that's what you're going to get to see today is some glazing.
Hold 15 minutes, enter, and start.
Okay, here is what just came out of the kiln load and what you just saw me glaze. That's the red, the scarlet, and black. I really liked how they turned out. I think that one to me is so far a favorite. I have some turquoise or some ones that ended up being teal. I'm gonna call them teal spiral bowls. But anyway, for the most part, those turned out great. These right here, I think, are one of my favorites, this little set here. Oh, it didn't blur like I thought it would, and I think it's because I fixed my clear. My clear glaze, actually, I just applied it a little more thin and put a little more water in it. This basket right here, I adore it. I really do. Oh, I love that. It's not, see how the inside, I'm going to show this to you. Some people may not like it, but I really, really, it makes me happy to see that it's imperfect. I didn't want a solid black interior on that bowl. This is just a hand-built tray I made with scraps. It's kind of small, but I just love it. I love how the black goes in all the little grooves. You know, everybody has their personal preference, but I'm gonna tell you what I'm thinking and what my preferences are. This, right here, this little bowl and plate, I made separately, two different things, but I put them together because I'm gonna actually sell them as a set on Etsy because I think they're just really cute. This one right here, when I went to glaze it, I grabbed it real quick off the shelf, put the black wash on, and when I was wiping it off, I realized, oh, look at that, I actually carved little lines in it, and to
to me, this is an extremely cute little bowl. And this one, I'm not going to say much about this one because I really like it, but I want you to think of what you feel like when you see it. All right, I got to say this. This is probably the key thing I'm trying to achieve every time I black wash something. When I look at the texturing and I can see every little groove, I get really happy with the cracks. Anytime I see little crackles and things with the black inside it, it makes me so happy because that's what I'm trying to achieve. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this kiln opening. I am ready to start tomorrow on my new 30 days, 30 bowls, and 30 techniques. Come join me. Hopefully, I'm gonna learn some new things and share some new things and come up with some amazing things, and I'm real excited to get creative with you guys. So thanks for joining, and we will see you next time.